What is up, guys? It's Tommy here and welcome to the West Ham United Liverpool preview and analysis video. First of all, let me know what is your prediction for this huge, huge game. Liverpool absolutely have to win this game if we want to catch up and get closer to the top four. Chelsea are playing Manchester United tomorrow, and also Manchester City are playing Arsenal. So Arsenal probably will drop points, either 2 or even 3 points. I can see Man City winning that game. And also Chelsea, Man United, you know, if either team drop points or even both teams drop points with a draw, if Liverpool win at West Ham, which is no easy task, but Liverpool can do it, then it would be a huge advantage. We could get closer to the top four, and this is, I think, a turning point in Liverpool's season. Liverpool have conceded the most goals away from home in the Premier League. We conceded 15 goals in 5 games. And in 5 home games, we just conceded 1 goal. So it's a huge contrast between Liverpool's home and away form. And Liverpool absolutely has to fix the defense. Jurgen Klopp, I'm sure, is working really, really hard on the training ground. Lovren getting injured is probably a best blessing in disguise, because he has been all over the place recently, especially against Tottenham. But against Huddersfield and Maribor, both games, Liverpool's defense haven't been tested. Liverpool actually kept 4 clean sheets in their past 5 games, but those 4 clean sheets came against the likes of Maribor home and away, against the likes of Huddersfield, who really just parked the bus and didn't really attack Liverpool. So I don't think that Liverpool's defensive problems are gone. But with Matip and Klavan and also Joe Gomez, I think Liverpool can keep a clean sheet at West Ham. But I think what will be the key in this game is, can we finish our chances? Because when we do, we can win any game of football, in my opinion. I think, Coutinho is most likely will be out. Jurgen Klopp said that Mane is close, he's training well, but maybe this game is too soon for him after his hamstring injury. Lovren and Wijnaldum are also out injured. Wijnaldum got a swollen ankle injury against Maribor. So Liverpool actually have quite a lot of injury worries. Lallana is still out. So Wijnaldum, Coutinho, Lallana, 3 very, very important midfield players for Liverpool. But Milner has been doing really, really well recently. And also Emre Can has scored a goal against Maribor and has played well in that game. Sturridge, I think, should start in this one with Salah and Firmino on either side of Sturridge, but Coutinho or Mane could still come back in to the lineup if they can pass fit before the game. So I'm really, really nervous, but also really excited to watch this game. And also, big update, guys, today I can move back to my house in the evening, and I'm so, so happy about that. I'm recording a Liverpool career mode video after this video goes up on YouTube, so that should be out in the evening. And also I will cover the West Ham Liverpool game, so really, really excited about this weekend. I can make again, finally, a lot more videos than I probably did in the past few weeks. So I apologies for this lack of videos, but I'm really, really looking forward to the season, the rest of the season, because I can upload 5 times as many videos as I have done in the past month. And Liverpool's strongest 11 is probably includes Coutinho and Mane and Lallana, so Liverpool are a little bit weakened, but still, that doesn't explain how badly Liverpool have done away from home in the Premier League. And I still feel that with better finishing, Liverpool could have won against, not necessarily against Tottenham or Man City, but against some of the other sides. And I think gradually Liverpool are improving, but I can understand the fans' frustration. I feel that as well. I'm so, so frustrated, because I was really, really hoping that Liverpool would challenge for the league title. At the moment, Man City are starting the season like no other team has started the Premier League season before. They got 9 wins and 1 draw. That's the best start ever from any Premier League side in the history of Premier League. That shows that Man City started like a house on fire. But you know, they will hit a rough patch, in my opinion. They won't go the season unbeaten, that's my prediction, and probably they will win the title, but if a team can be consistent enough, and I sadly I can't say that I expect Liverpool to be consistent enough, that's our biggest problem, then you know, Man City are certainly not champions yet, and Pep Guardiola himself said that about Man City's you know, title hopes. And what's very interesting for me, I'm looking at the stats, that Liverpool conceded 0.2 goals per game at home, but away from home, Liverpool conceded 3 goals per game. Unbelievable. At home, Liverpool kept 4 clean sheets in the Premier League. Away from home, Liverpool kept 0 clean sheets. And also, what is very, very staggering is that from Liverpool's 5 home games, the opposition had 1.2 shots on target. But away from home, the opposition had 6.4 shots on target. That's like 5 times as many shots on target. Can you believe that? That's absolutely mental, in my opinion. So, I really, really hope that this is the game with West Ham-Liverpool, where Liverpool start to climb the table and start to put a winning run together. We won against Huddersfield, absolutely brilliant game, 3-0, but you know, in the first half, Liverpool were pretty slow in the build-up. We had 13 shots in the first half against Huddersfield, but just 1 on target, so Liverpool have been very wasteful. But in the second half, it was a different team. I think Jurgen Klopp had some harsh words to say to Liverpool. And in the second half, we scored early. We even missed the penalty. And I will talk about the penalties in a second. And then in the end, we steamrolled Huddersfield. I was so happy that Sturridge came on. And Sturridge started against Huddersfield and he scored, but against Maribor he came on as a substitute and he scored again. So that's why I think that Sturridge deserves to start against West Ham. Last season we went to West Ham in a must-win game and we ran out 3-0 winners. Coutinho put Sturridge through and he finished brilliantly. And I think Sturridge should get a run of games now that Coutinho is out injured, Mane is still out injured. It's now or never where Sturridge gets a run of games, in my opinion, and Jurgen Klopp should give Sturridge a chance, because I know that he doesn't have the work rate of Firmino, he doesn't do high pressing as well as Firmino, but he's our best finisher, in my honest opinion, he's our best finisher, and to think that Mohamed Salah is our top scorer with 10 goals, and Salah probably missed 10 or 12 clear-cut chances apart from scoring those 10 goals, so on another day, or in another universe, Salah could be on 20 goals now already. He missed that many chances throughout the games. And Salah has been the signing of the season so far in the Premier League. Let me stress that, so far, absolutely brilliant. I just wish that Jurgen Klopp made a centre-back signing, made a defensive signing, even somebody like De Vrij from Lazio or Davinson Sanchez, who in the end ended up at Tottenham and he looks like a brilliant young player. And I kept banging on about this, that we cannot gamble on being able to sign Van Dijk in the summer, because it will come back and bite us if in the end, and that turned out to be what happened, the Van Dijk transfer fell through, we couldn't persuade Southampton to do a deal. Nobody else bid for Van Dijk because other clubs knew that if they bid for Van Dijk, that will encourage Liverpool to bid for Van Dijk as well. And in the end, we ended up with no new centre-backs at the club. And look at us, only like 4 teams conceded more goals in the Premier League in the first 10 games. And that's shocking, that I never thought that I will see a Liverpool team concede so many goals in the first like 9 games of the Premier League season. 16 goals in 9 games conceded, absolutely incredible. And also 15 goals conceded in 5 away games. That's a record that I never thought I would see a Liverpool team do, especially 2 years after Jurgen Klopp is the Liverpool manager. And I can understand why the fans feel frustrated with Klopp, because I agree with them in the sense that I think that Jurgen Klopp should have made Liverpool more consistent and we should have seen more progress from the team in the 2 years since Jurgen Klopp has been the manager, and when you consider that the only two centre backs, only two defenders who we spent money on is Andrew Robertson and Ragnar Klavan since Klopp took over, is nothing short of like baffling and very shocking, in fact, very very surprising, because before Jurgen Klopp came in, the biggest weakness of Liverpool was defense. And since Jurgen Klopp came in, that didn't change. And that's my biggest problem with the whole tenure of Jurgen Klopp. I wanted to comment on this issue because it's a hot topic among Liverpool fans at the moment. Going forward, Liverpool is brilliant to watch. One of the most entertaining teams to watch. And midfield-wise, we are pretty okay. I still feel that we need Naby Keita in the midfield and maybe another like very creative player. But if Coutinho plays in midfield and, you know, Firmino, Salah and Mane plays up front, then creativity-wise, we are okay in the midfield. I still feel that Naby Keita is needed for the Liverpool midfield to go up a level. But defensively, Liverpool are shocking. I still think that we should upgrade on Mignolet, and I still think that we should sell Lovren and get a replacement who is even better than Joao Mati, but at least on the level of Joao Mata, who is of course also not immune to criticism. He made some mistakes as well, but Liverpool's style of play is such that it leaves defenders very exposed and in huge open spaces. And for example, you have seen Sergio Ramos, one of the best defenders in the world. He has been exposed against Tottenham when Real Madrid ran forward and Tottenham counter-attacked Real Madrid, and it was Harry Kane or Dele Alli running at Sergio Ramos, and he looked petrified, and he didn't look like a world-class centre-back running when they were running at him. So I think Liverpool's style of play of course doesn't suit the defenders, but still I expect Liverpool to do much much better. So the big question is, can Liverpool score early against West Ham? Can we silence the crowd? Because West Ham, in my opinion, will sit back and soak up the pressure. But West Ham is a team of two faces. They can be brilliant on their day and they can beat anyone, but also they can be absolutely atrocious. They lost 3-0 to Brighton at home recently, but they also went to Wembley. They were trailing Tottenham 2-0 and they came back and won 3-2. So anything can happen with this game. I mean, West Ham and Liverpool are both very, very inconsistent, so it's anybody's guess what will happen. I still believe in this Liverpool team, that we can do something special, but we need to win these kind of games. Away from home against West Ham, after dropping so many points already this season, this is the time for Liverpool to step up and put some wins on the board. So come on, Liverpool, let's do this. Thanks for watching, hope you enjoyed this. See you later, guys. Good night.